Hello and welcome to Homeschooling Today magazine. I am Trisha Hodges, also known as Hodgepodge Mom, and we are very grateful to be here on the Facebook page to share with you today a Man on the Moon art tutorial. And you will want to stay around because we have a bonus tutorial to share with you as well. Now, before we get started, I will introduce you to Nana, and the children are here with us as well. Nana will share with you just the few supplies that you'll need. You're welcome to watch this tutorial first, or you may follow along and do it with us. I also wanted to mention to you that we have a very special code just for all of you viewers. At chalkpastel.com, we have 25% off all of the space art that we share, and that is with the code HSTODAYMAG. I will turn the camera around in just a minute and show that to you. With the solar eclipse coming up and all of the wonderful anniversaries of space this summer, we're excited to share this tutorial with you. So let me turn this around and I will introduce Nana to you.
Hello there, my artist friends. Welcome to our painting party this afternoon. Yes, these are paints. Pure pigment in a stick. And that's why we call painting with pastels. Today, we're going to do an anniversary painting of the first man that walked on the moon. So what we've done is we have a sheet of regular old black construction paper here, and it's turned in the horizontal or the fat way, not the skinny way, but the fat way, horizontal. And we're going to take our white chalks first. Let's look at these pastels I picked out. Now you can't get much more simple than this. Red, white, and blue. And that's what's in this one. I have an extra white just in case. All right, about a quarter of the way down, we're going to start with the horizon on the moon. Now you don't need to worry about filling it in just absolutely solid. Just keep it on the white pastel on its side and just kind of lightly add your color. Now if you get to the edge and you feel like that just doesn't look good to me, you can take your fingers or your fist and go ahead and smooth it out to the edge. All right, the first thing we are going to put on the moon is our flag. Now, the flagpole and the flag itself is going to be rather tall. There it is. You see, it stretches out above the horizon. Okay, then we're going to get our flag itself in. I think I'm going to put it in with white. Now there is, I have seen in pictures taken from the moon, there is a tiny bit of a wind. Now, I don't know, I'm not an astronaut, so I'm not really sure. There's the flag. And then we're going to put blue background in, color it solid. Now we can't get all of the stripes in because this flag is waving. So put in as many as you like, but you don't have to put in real number of stripes because this is an impression of the flag. Okay. its glory on the moon. Now, we got to put some stars in on the blue background. So, go ahead and put your stars in. Now, all right, we're going to put Neil Armstrong over here, and he's going to be looking at the moon. And this is a rough drawing, free-handed, of an astronaut. Okay, and here's the end of his space suit, and there is his. Right. Now they wore really clunky boots. I think it helped them to grip the surface. I'm going to make Neil's head a little bit taller there. And he has a backpack on that has all of his breathing apparatus in there. Now, there is a visor that is on his face that protects him. Let's get that on there. Like I say, this is free-handed. You do the best you can. I'm sure it will be just wonderful. Now for this, you can take your finger and kind of smooth it around till it's the way you want it. I'm not going to smooth that back leg so you can tell that is his back leg. Make this a bit more rounded. There. Now let's give it a little bit of landscape. And I forgot to, did you get a black? Okay, I forgot to get the black. Let's make a shadow from his feet all the way going to the edge of the paper, because the sun is shining on him. And there's also some tracks of the lunar rover. And you can kind of make an impression of the tire tracks. And there's also some footprints around the flag, because he had to walk around over there. Set the flag up, and he walked around over here to make sure that it looked all right. And if you want to, you can give him some footprints to where he's standing here. Now, you can make him a little bit more distinct. You can outline him. And even if you want to, this is a little extra, even if you want to, you can make the beautiful blue planet in the distance. Now, can anybody tell me what planet this might be?
Earth.
That's exactly right. And you take your green and you can put, there's South America and there's the United States. This is just an impression. And here's Africa. And there is Europe. The beautiful blue planet. And put some of the ocean in. And you can kind of just make it an impression of the way it looks. And let's see. Let's have the sun shining on the left-hand side. Just a little bit. Now, I think this is wonderful. And I know that you have done a wonderful job too. Now, won't you just sign it here in the corner? Take your painting, flip it over, and name it Moonwalk or Art in Space. And today's date. And hang this in a place of real honor, because you know what? People will say, I know what this is. You are really an artist.
Y'all stay tuned, because we're going to get a brand new sheet of black construction paper. And let's do a spiral galaxy.
Okay. Now, this time around, yes, we do have black construction paper, but we're going to turn it the skinny way, or vertical, like this, up and down like this. Now, your interpretation of this is your interpretation, meaning this is your spiral galaxy, not mine. I'm just showing you what I think it looks like. You can use the colors that you prefer, or make it big or tiny or whatever. Let's get started, because this is most fun. You get to use all of your hands for this. Okay, let's start sort of in the middle. I've got mine over here to the side a little bit. We've got a brilliant white spot. And then around that, I'm going to put pink. How about that? Okay. And then we're going to take our white again, and we're going to go around like this. If you get into the pink, it's okay. No worries. And we're going to go tight around here, and then going to go zoom off this and zoom off like this. Now you might think that you're through. Well, you're not. Take your two painter fingers, and you can kind of smooth all this color and go outside the line. See how you make it look like maybe some gas in the atmosphere. It's really going fast. It's twirling fast and fast and fast. And it's leaving a trail here, right over here, and a trail over here. Look at this, look at this. Let's get in here in this pink and make it kind of swirly. You can even take the side of your fist, see my fist? And you can fist these colors. Get into it. Make it yours. If you want to have a purple color in the middle, you go ahead and have that purple. All right, now this is the fun part. We're going to make some far, far, far away stars that are in this spiral galaxy. There's some way up here. Now, don't make it look like it's snowing. Just a few touches will get the idea across. Oops. And there might even be some along the inside. And then down here. You could spend all afternoon painting spiral galaxies. Let me get some of this pink up here, because I think it's so pretty. And my students have done some beautiful work. I know you have too. So take your brightest color and sign your name in the corner. Your name, not my name, because I'm the Nana here. And flip it over, name it Spiral Galaxy or Space Picture and today's date. And I think this would be an excellent picture to go in some people's rooms, so that when they even could put it on the ceiling, so when they wake up, they would say, oh, look at my beautiful spiral galaxy. Didn't I have fun drawing and painting this? And people would just love it because you've done such a good job. And they will know by looking at this, you are an artist.
Thank you, Nana, and thank you, Homeschooling Today Magazine, for having us here on the Facebook page today. We want to let you know that I'm going to share a link here in the comments to a download of this Spiral Galaxy art tutorial. And also, I'm going to share one more link on the Homeschooling Today website. We've shared an art tutorial of this nebula, and you might enjoy that as well, all of you that are enjoying space art studies this summer and throughout the year. So we look forward to seeing your pictures of that art. We would love for you to share those pictures at the hashtag YouAreAnArtist, and we would comment on those. You can tag us on Instagram at ChalkPastelArt. And remember that special code for 25% off any of the space art that we offer. Thanks so much for joining us, you artists. And remember, as Nana said, you are an artist.